Hyve responded to the groups, the community's needs for self-management and to get to know more about their condition. So we've set up the Hyve so that people can come and have their blood pressure, blood glucose, cholesterol checked, and then they have a record of it, they learn more about it, and then there will be it would be easier and better for them to relate to their health care professionals, including their GP.
I'm involved with the Hyve, doing the blood pressures, the cholesterol, and the blood sugar. And depending on the result of the blood sugar, I will do the HB1AC as well. But at the moment, I'm still practicing to use the machine. So by the 18th, I hope that I'll be very proficient in it. But being as I was an ex-nurse, I'm an ex-nurse, already proficient in the blood pressure and the cholesterol and other things like that. But hopefully, I hope I will be an access to people that come to the Hyve and hope to give them encouragement and to do the best I can to help people.
It's quite sad that it is necessary, to be quite honest with you, but I think it's important. Prevention is always important, and as I said in my speech, I'm not too enamoured with the fact that we're doing self-management, but I understand the reasons behind it. I think the fact is that the NHS should be putting more funds into prevention because diabetes costs the country billions of pounds. But I welcome what's been done through Denzil and through Unis for the simple reason that it will get to people and make people more comfortable. And they will not necessarily be treated, but they will be identified as having problems within their own community by the people themselves, by people of their own community, which is important. And then that information is transferred onto their own GP. So yes, it's really good that they've come up with this initiative, and I'm glad that it's been funded, and I'm glad they've been funded through the lottery, you know, in particular. But I'm quite happy that the outcomes will be good.
I was actually one of the founding members of the Hunnies back in 2002, with my mum, Dorothy Clayton. So I've been involved with it for a very long time, and then after returning to Huddersfield after medical school and becoming a GP, I was invited back to tell the other side, the medical side, to diabetes and help support the Hunnies some more.
We have a community who is very low in knowledge of their condition, even though the condition is rife in our community. And we see from day to day people suffering with all the complications of diabetes. And they shouldn't really get to that complicated state. If they started by taking, understanding what is happening to them, and start to take control of their condition, they wouldn't get to the complications and end up in hospital and things like that. A number of our community, in fact a substantial number of our community, is going into hospital with unplanned diabetes problems. So we responded to that emergency by giving people the opportunity to nip it in the bud, start on the preventative approach, and to get them to check themselves before things get to a bad state.
Well, I think it's important because it looks as though people are doing something for themselves, and that's that in itself is it means that the communities are coming together. And I'm quite happy, and as I said in there, I'm quite happy to support them through my own charity fundraising to the tune of £2,000. And you know, it's not a small amount of money, but it's not a massive amount of money. But I think something like that will help them achieve what they've set out to do.
It's important because diabetes is so daunting to a lot of people, and it's scary. This kind of project gives people somewhere safe to come, somewhere in the community, somewhere non-threatening for those who don't know if they have diabetes or want to find out. But also it's a wonderful resource to help support them in their long-term management of their condition.
Well, it is important because the thing is, we think people know a lot about diabetes, and the doctors and the diabetic nurse give them a lot of information. But sometimes when you talk to people, they don't know a lot. So I think this is why I think there's where we come in. We'll be very explicit, I believe, and able to help people in a more grassroots manner, a way which they could understand and be more comfortable with it. Because as it is, when you go to the doctor, the doctor haven't got a lot of time. So everybody is going at a pace. But coming here, we probably might be able to give them a little bit more time.
We have this pilot running for 15 weeks. It's from now until the 17th of August. And we run from here at the St. John's Resource Centre every Wednesday from 10 till 1, 10 in the morning to 1 in the afternoon, where people can come and have all the vital elements associated with diabetes checked, blood pressure, glucose, have the feet checked, etc., etc.
Thank you.